My primary mandate is to come here and to start getting the spending to turn down and say, how do we start turning them back? We've started that. When this goes over to the Senate, I have every confidence that they're going to pass the CR. That will be $10 billion that we've cut over 5 weeks. That is a major cut that started. So even while we're waiting for the big piece to go, we've already cut $10 billion trying to get the big one in so we can finish this out. Now, it passed overwhelmingly, but there were 54 Republicans that said, no, I'm not voting for that. But it's all over the map. I talked to quite a few of them to say, okay, why did you vote against it? And for them, they were asking me the same thing. Why did you vote for it? I got answers like, you know what, it's not a big enough cut. I want even bigger. I got some that were saying it didn't include certain environmental provisions in it. I got some that were saying it was the abortion issue. Some were saying I really wanted Obamacare to be in this particular CR. And so we're all over the map on the things that are issues. So there's no one single issue to say the conference is divided because of this issue. There are a lot of issues they're looking at. Each one is looking at what are their constituents saying to them, and they're coming and voting based on that. So what we've got to do, and what is a common agreement, is we need to cut spending, we need to be more efficient in what we're doing, and we need to get a budget. We need to get this done. And I'm one of those saying we can't just do CRs forever. I don't know what that means, because we're waiting on the Senate to do its job. And so when the Senate sends a piece back, then we can start the negotiation process and figure out, but we have no idea what the Senate's proposal even is, because they've tried two different times and they can't pass anything just on their own, much less passing ours.